Seems like all I could see was the struggle. Haunted by ghosts that lived in my past, bound up in shackles of all my failures, wondering how long is this gonna last. Then you look at this prisoner and say to me, son, stop fighting a fight, it's already been won. And I am redeemed. You set me free. So I'll shake off these heavy chains. I am redeemed. I'm redeemed. All my life I have been called unworthy. Named by the voice of my shame and regret. So I'll shake off these heavy chains and wipe away every stain, 'cause I'm not who I used to be. I am redeemed. You set me
redeemed. All right, well done, ladies. Fantastic. Now, are y'all going to be doing the second song as well? All right, fantastic. We have them doing Gracefully Broken. Thank you.
Take all I have in these hands and multiply, God, all that I am, and find my heart on the altar again. Set me on fire, set me on fire. Oh, take all I have in these hands and multiply, God, all that I am, and find my heart on the altar again. Set me on fire, oh, set me on fire. Here I am, God, arms wide open, pouring out my life, gracefully broken. My heart stands in awe of your name, your mighty love stands strong to the end. You will fulfill your purpose for me. You won't forsake me, you will be with me. Here I am, God, arms wide open, pouring out my life, gracefully broken, pouring out my life again. Here I God, arms wide open. arms wide open. Pouring out my life, gracefully broken.
All right, well done, ladies. Well done. All right. Next up on our list, we have Miss, I was a little quick, I'm sorry about that. Miss Janie Ball. Fantastic. And she will be singing Speak the Name. And we have Miss her singing here, that she has been working with the stomach, correct? It's been fantastic. And we have your track. Good.
I was thinking this morning, it's probably been 2 or 3 years since I've sang without the ladies. So normally when I've been singing, everybody's watching them. So I told them they're going to have to come up and hold my hand.
Atmosphere is changing. Nothing stays the same. Heaven is waiting for the mention of the name. The Spirit is moving, burning like a flame. Healing the broken by the one we proclaim. Raise it up, fill the sky. Chains will fall, mountains move, we'll lift him high. Speak the name above all the other names. Speak the name the wind and waves obey.
Thank you.
much, Janie. All right, next up, we welcome to the stage AJ Hairston and his dad. Come on, Andrew. AJ. Oh, and the whole family. Awesome. Yes, sir. All right. All right. All right. Okay. Yeah, let me get one closer to you there, boss. Yep. This one? Roger, roger.
Here you go.
Here you go, AJ. There you go. There you go. All right. All right, AJ. Now, what will you be singing?
You want to tell them what you're singing?
What are you going to be singing?
Tell them in the microphone.
Amazing Grace.
All right.
You know, it's, of course, anybody that's got young kids, you struggle with how to teach them God's word because they're 3 and 18 months and they're peeing and pooping while you're trying to read a story to them. And then I get grossed out and I start throwing up and Jesse's cleaning up everybody's messes. But one thing that we tried to do is teach them about the grace of God, not just a bunch of rules. Because if you read the Bible as a bunch of rules, you're going to fail. It's designed that way. It's to teach you your dependency on Christ. And so I didn't know any other way. Jesse didn't know any other way than to put it to music for them so that maybe it would mean something to them and just let God work like only He can work. And it's kind of funny. I've been going through Ephesians. And I was telling the praise team this morning, Holly said she had been going through Ephesians, so maybe it's just meant to be. But when you get to Ephesians 2, it says, as for you, you were dead in your transgressions and sins. It doesn't say you were pretty bad or you needed help. We were dead. In which the way you used to live, you followed the ways of the world and the ruler of the kingdom of the air. And so we were following the ways of Satan. And then you get to verse 4, and it's the best two words in the whole Bible, but God. And then if you notice, Paul puts like in the middle of that, it doesn't even make sense, just real quick, by grace you were saved. And then he goes on and he comes back to that later. But it's like he was just hammering home a point. It is the grace of God. It's not a decision that we make. It's not a set of rules. It's not us wanting to become a better person. It is the grace of God that just like Paul plucks you off the road and says, you're mine. And so we've been teaching AJ Amazing Grace, and it is just, it's just wonderful to hear him sing. And he's shy, so I hope he sings it. We've been practicing, and Jesse's going to help him because she can actually sing. So.
Yeah. Oh.
Here you go, Mr. Justin. All right, up next, already making it to the stage, Brian Northcutt and Sydney with Psalms 51.
Is that what you had, Andrew? This one right here?
Yes.
Strength is gone. You're faithful forever. And I know you'll never let me fall.
I want to give a round of applause to Andrew for teaching his kids doctrine. So, one of the things that we've done in our home, especially in the last year, is to try to teach doctrine through songs. And there's lots of several groups out there that can help you with that. And another thing that Claire has done, which she's extremely talented at, is just take scripture, just make up harmonies with it or make up melody lines with scripture. So that's what this is. Claire, this is written by King David in Psalms 51, but Claire put it to music, and Sydney has learned it. She's been playing her ukulele for a while. Hey, this is not on. She knows that it's... She's just concerned that it's not on. So she's really nervous, but we're excited, and I'm going to help her out. But she's going to do a great job. This is Psalm 51. Claire put this to music, and this is it. Stain of my sin,
to know your joy.
Next up, we have Denny McKinney. Denny McKinney. Oh, my bad. All right. Then will Cynthia Bell and Ella Kate Hamilton come to the stage. And this one will be on the track, gentlemen. And they will be singing Nothing But the Blood.
Can wash
wash away my sin. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh, precious is the flow that makes me white as snow. No other fount I know. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Nothing but the blood of
Next up, we have Ken Lambert singing a couple of original songs for us.
Good job.
Dark and all alone, growing comfortable. Are you too scared to move? Walk out of this tomb, buried underneath the lies that you believed. Safe and sound, stuck in the ground, too lost to be found. You're just asleep, and it's time to leave. Come on, take a breath, you're alive now. Can't you hear the voice?
Can you hear me? Can you see me? Okay. One, two. I love the psalm being put to music. That's great. I'm real picky. Yeah, turn the monitor down. I don't need that stuff. Get the stuff out of my way. I'm bashful, too. Everybody lately has been so concerned with the tumult that this country has been undergoing for so long. And one of the things that they pray, the scripture, is 2 Chronicles 7:14. If my people, the biggest word in the Bible, I believe, is if my people. And I love that particular passage. And I did, like Sydney did with her psalm, I put it to music. You're welcome to sing along if you want to, because I sound a lot better when people sing with me. If my people, who are called by my name, will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and will heal their land. That's Father God's promise. That's how it will be for our country, our nation, this sweet land of the free. That's the hope of a future that our children may see. And that's Father God's promise for you and for me. If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways. If my people. Thank you. I went through a pretty long period of being a real rascal, for lack of a better word, and I was pretty much a drunk and a carouser, and my wife put up with a bunch of junk from me for a long time. And that all started coming to an end one night when she told me flat out that she was leaving. She had had enough. She was done. And that brought me to my face on the floor. So what I'm getting at is sometimes a church doesn't necessarily have to be a building like this. It can be on your face on the floor of your home. It was for me. I wrote this little song shortly after being saved at a late age. I was almost 60 years old. I'm an old man. I'm 80 years. I'll be 81 in a couple of months. I'm the eldest, except for Barry, of course. He's older than me. And I'm so glad God lets me still do this. And this is called That Old Country Church, and it's sort of my testimony. Just standing there in front of that old country church that day. Well, I was driving back from Dallas. It was early Sunday morning, and the choir was singing, "I'll Fly Away." I stepped inside the doorway just in time to hear the chorus, "When I Die, Hallelujah, By and By." And when the song was over, I sat down there on the back pew, and I hung my head, and I began to cry. Well, I cried for all those lonely nights, and I cried for all those drunken fights, and I cried for that sweet baby girl of mine. And I cried down on my bended knees, "Oh Father God, forgive me please. Let her take me back, Lord, one more time." Stepped into the aisle, I made my way down to the altar, and I knelt down and I prayed in Jesus' name. And the whole church sang Amazing Grace, as close I felt His warm embrace, and I knew my life would never be the same. Yeah. she took me back. It took some time, but now she's really truly mine. And now we know what love is all about. Now I've gone back many times to search, but find no trace of that old church. And some things I can't explain, but there's no doubt. That church was put there just for me. It's there if you have eyes to see. The truth is there if you have ears to hear. So if you're on that road today and need a place to kneel and pray, just come on in. He's waiting for you there. And I don't know how it happened, how I found myself just standing there front of that old country church that day. Praise God. Amen. Thank you. Appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you, Ken. All right, next up we have Randy Wagoner.
Sorry. You know it. I don't know why it's so hard to admit it. But being honest is the only way to fix it. There's no failure, no fall. There's no sin you don't already know. Yeah, I know. There's no failure, no fall. There's no sin you don't know. So let the truth be told. I still see the steeple. Church on.
Here we go. AJ. Your dad, Andrew, put me up to this, too. Yeah.
See what happens.
Hey, this is real fresh. Like, we ain't practicing nothing. Like,
I think this was put together at 10 minutes to 6.
I mean, we pretty much made an agreement right there.
This has come up a wee bit.
Line at the altar, and every pew had been filled.
I know where to start.
I'm remembering.
I heard an old, old story. By the way, this is Victory and Jesus, and yeah. This is a song that I'd hear in my head. I'd play this. I'd sing this with my church as a kid, and I remember growing up in the church that everybody would sing so loud you never could hear yourself. So it just plays in my head. So when Andrew said, "Yeah, you gonna sing something tonight? You coming tonight?" Oh, the only one I can put, you know, it's a song that's been playing in my head. So here it is. And the thing is, when we would sing it growing up in my church, there's a little part in there that says, "His redeeming blood." Now, there's a pause there, and everybody in the building would shout, "Praise God!" So, could you do that? I mean, we probably need to run through it 2 or 3 or 4 times. But could you do that? His redeeming blood, praise God! I don't know if we need to do that twice. Wow, okay. All right, can I get, let me know when I'm supposed to start singing. Here we go. I heard an old, old story, how Savior came from glory. He laid his life on Calvary to save a wretch like me. I heard about his groaning, of his precious blood atoning. Then I repented of my sin and won the victory. Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior forever. He sought me and bought me with his redeeming blood. From the air I knew him, and all my love is to him. He plunged me to victory beneath the cleansing flood. I heard about his healing, of his cleansing power revealing, how he made the lame to walk again and caused the blind to see. And then I cried, dear Jesus, come and heal my broken spirit. And somehow Jesus came and brought to me the victory. Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior forever. He sought me and bought me with his redeeming blood. He loved me and I knew him, and all my love is due him. He plunged me to victory beneath the cleansing flood. I heard about a mansion he has built for me in glory. And I heard about the streets of gold beyond the crystal sea. Someone threw me singing the old redemption story. And some sweet day I'll sing up there the song of victory. Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior forever. He bought me and sought me with his redeeming blood. Praise God! He loved me ere I knew him, and all my love is to him. He plunged me to victory beneath the cleansing blood.
I think we all needed that. What about y'all? Choir singing old hymns. There's a peace in the valley. Oh, as the preacher man he said, in the name of the Father, the name of the Son, the name of the Spirit, you're washed by the blood and buried with Christ, raised in new life, baptized. I can still hear the sermon.
We have Julianne Davis with All My Hope.
Song change we're doing. Yeah. We're doing Graves to Gardens. If y'all have heard it, you can sing along. I searched the world, but it couldn't feel me. The man's empty. satisfied here in the love. Oh, there's nothing better than you, Lord. There's nothing better than you, Lord. There's nothing is better than you.
All right, well done, Julian and Bo. Next up, we have Eden Shavers and Christian Allen. And they will be doing an original, and I believe he is going to speak on it when he gets up here.
Oh, power. The Holy Spirit rushing in. There was peace like the river. But when the preacher man said, the name of the Spirit, you're washed by the blood, I'm buried with Christ, raised in new life, baptized. Oh, those old stained glass windows and the stories they tell. Oh,
All right. So this is Psalms 39. Before we play, I want to make this aware. This is one of the laments of the Bible. So this isn't really happy go giddy. Just letting you know, like, throughout the entire chapter or whatever, he's lamenting, as you would understand, being very, very, Psalms 39 is, as I said, a lament. It expresses an emotion opposite to that of praise, but it is still praising itself. The writer opens up his heart honestly to God, a heart filled with sadness from something going on. And so I just want to make that aware.
I will watch my ways and keep my tongue from sin. I put a muzzle on my mouth in the presence of the wicked. So I remain still, not even saying good. But my anguish increased, and the flames grew hot within me. And while I meditated, the fire burned. And then I spoke with my tongue. Show me, Lord, my life's end, and the number of my days. Let me know how fleeting my life is. You have made my days a mere hand's breadth. The span of my years is nothing before you.
Thank you, Eden and Christian. Next up, we have the Northcutts.
Oh.
you'll see the steeple, a little church on the hill. Why you ever chose me has always been a mystery. All my life I've been told I belong at the end of the line with all the other not quite, with all the never get it right.
Thank you. Here we go.
But it turns out they're the ones you were looking for all this.
I think that's too, that may be too close. All right, no Von Trapp jokes. Please, just leave those alone. So, these are songs that we sing in our family Devo times. And before you have any ideas of grandeur, Daddy usually gets mad in these songs and has to stop them and start them all over again. So it takes us a long time. But the good news is we get a lot of practice. So, and we get a lot of Daddy repenting of his anger. So, but we're going to give it a shot. This is our first time. We just worked on it. We play these songs all the time at our house. But this is the first time they've done it here, and Claire's going to help out. And this is Isaac's first time on the drums. So, I mean, he's been playing drums for a couple of years, but this is his first time here. So we just worked this out today.
Your voice now, no love is greater.
If I'm lost. Eli.
But I'm so filled with fear, I can barely move. Doubt, I've had my share of doubt, but never more than right now. I'm wondering, where are you? Here on the edge of fall. Somehow you
promises find my troubled heart.
All right, I moved over here.
This is the truth I'm standing on, even when all my strength is gone.
So one of the things that I've always admired about Claire is whatever's going on, she's always running to the Lord. And in fact, that was the, other than her being good looking, that was the second thing I was looking most for in a wife, was one who, when problems came, they went to the Lord. And we discovered, well, she helped me learn how to write. And so a lot of her pain and mourning comes out in the form of writing. And so she's going to share a few songs for you that she has written.
I would love nothing better than to end the night right now. It's such a sweet moment for me. I shared with Kim that when we told our worship teams goodbye in 2013, we told them we were moving here to record. And as most of you know, that hasn't happened. And it's interesting to see how God allows a dream to be birthed, and then he requires us to allow it to die. And tonight, he's resurrected a dream for me 8 years later, watching my children here on stage. And it's so fitting that we're sharing the song that we're sharing right now. Philippians, I've got it in Galatians 1. Philippians 1:6 is where this song comes from. And it is very simply says that the God who started a good work in you is not going to quit until he's finished, and he's faithful to complete it.
When I take my eyes off you, fear is crippling, and the pain, it shuts me down. All I know is where I've been. The trouble I have seen makes it hard to move ahead. But you're working on me, God. You're not finished with me yet. Lord, you're making me something beautiful. Those around me cannot see what you're doing. Lord, you're making me something beautiful. Those around you're doing, and I find my hope in you, find my hope in you, find my hope in you. I find my peace in you, find my peace in you, find my peace. Find my hope in you. done with me yet. I can be confident. You're not done with me yet. You're not done with me yet. I can be confident. You're not done with me yet. You're not done with me yet. I can be confident. You're not done with me yet. You're not done with me yet. I can be confident. You're not done with me yet. Lord, you're making me something beautiful. Those around me cannot see what you're doing.
Christmas of 2015, I had a breakdown and I couldn't breathe. Some of you know what that's like. If you don't, I hope you never do. And it's interesting because as I was practicing this, I thought of Ruth McClellan. And as imperfect as it was, I sent it to her. And we're worlds apart. But this is her story, and this is probably some of yours. If you can get it in the right key, we'll start.
Lord, I know something's gotta change. Oh, Lord, something's gotta give. Can't see straight. Sometimes it's hard to breathe. Won't you make a path and show me how to live? I need to take a step, but I don't know which way. I want to praise you, Lord, have purpose in my pain. You have put me here, you have made me weak. Let your grace be real to me.
Thank you.
Lord, you've put me in a foreign land. I get so weary, there's times it's hard to stand. I can't see straight, sometimes it's hard to breathe. Won't you make a path and show me how to live? Need contentment now, tame my unbelief. Pour your mercy out, give faith when I can't see. You have put me here, you have made me weak. Let your grace be strength to me. Make way. Sing with me. You're the way.
Thank you, Claire, Brian, and the Von Northcutts. Do we have anybody else that wants to sing? Anybody? Stuart, you got your cello? You good? Barry? All right. Well, let's give another round of applause for all the talent we had tonight. Fantastic. Thank y'all for coming out and listening and praising with us at Will's Valley Night of Praise. Let's give a big applause to Kim for arranging it. Stephen for running the sound. And once again, thank you all for coming out and encouraging this young talent and old talent, no offense. continue. I encourage y'all to continue to refining your talents for the glory of God. We had some amazing things happen up here tonight. We got to hear people praise and some people that I'd never heard before. And it's amazing at the talents that God has given y'all and in order to glorify Him. So continue to cultivate that and to use it. He gave it to you for a purpose and use it for that. And so, once again, thank y'all for coming up here and sharing with us. As for that, and since we have no one else, I'm going to close us out for prayer. And thank y'all again. Dear Heavenly Father God, thank you for sharing and giving these talents and these gifts so that you may be glorified and that you may be glorified, God. And it's that simple. We sing your praises. We take the lamentations from the Psalms and from your word and of our hearts, and we present them to you in song so that we have a way to communicate through song and prayer and to let us grow and bring them to you, God. I pray that you will go with all of these talents and everyone here that has heard, and let us continue to grow to you so that we may give you praise and glorify you as we go on our separate ways, God. In your name I pray, amen. Thank y'all.
Sometimes on this journey, I get lost in my mistakes. What looks to me like weakness is a canvas for your strength. And my story isn't over, my story's just begun. And failure won't define me, 'cause that's what my Father does. Yeah, failure won't define me, 'cause that's what my Father does.
Surround.
share.